I'm asked a lot these days, is now a good time to buy a house or should we wait? I'm hearing other realtors immediately say, absolutely. Interest rates are at historical lows. Your borrowing power is elevated because of this. Absolutely, do it now. While I totally agree with the low interest rate part of this general consensus, my answer to is now a good time to buy is not as blanketed as that. Buying a home is a major financial and a very personal decision. Today, I'm going to give you four signs to consider to personally figure out whether buying a house right now is a smart move or you might be better off waiting. Hi, I'm Lisa Kelly, Lakeland Homes and Lifestyles with Premier Realty. If you're new to my channel, welcome. I hope you could stay with me today because at the end of this short video, I have a 100% free bonus that's not only going to save you a lot of money, it's going to give you the tools to make even smarter decisions when buying a house. So let's get started. If you've been on your job or been doing the same type of work for the last 2 years, you may be ready to buy a house. When financing a home, lenders are going to want to see your W-2s or your 1099s, and they're also going to want to see 2 years of tax returns. This is their proof that you have the income to make your mortgage payments and can continue to do so for the foreseeable future. What's your DTI? Do you have a handle on your debt? Meaning, do you know your DTI number? Your debt-to-income ratio number needs to be 45% or less. If it is, you may be ready to buy a house. Figuring out your DTI number is easy. All you have to do is add up all your recurring monthly payments, like car payments, credit card payments, student loans. Then divide that number by your total monthly income, and then just multiply by 100 to get your percentage. If your DTI is more than 45%, it's worth focusing on getting a handle on your debt before buying a house. If you have steadily saved on a consistent basis and have around 5% of the cost of a house in the bank, you may be ready to buy a house. Notice that I said steadily saved on a consistent basis. A lender wants to see that you have the capacity not only to prepare for the cost of the home, but for the ongoing cost of home ownership as well. Making a sudden large deposit from a third party is not what they want to see. And this is just a bare minimum. There's other costs involved as well. For complete details on all the costs regarding buying a home, you'll want to check out my earlier video. What's your credit score and are you happy with it? If you have a credit score of 620 or higher, you may be ready to buy a house. There are some unique mortgage programs out there that can do a loan with a lower score, but you'll be paying a lot more for that home over time because you're not going to get a primo rate. The higher your credit score is the better rate that you're going to receive, which means that the more house you can qualify for. So you see, there's a little bit more to consider when simply asking, is now a good time to buy a house? If you think you might be ready to buy a house, please take advantage of my 100% free buyer's guide. In it, you're going to find money-saving tips and a step-by-step guide to properly prepare for home ownership. Just click the link in the description to get instant access to this valuable guide. Enjoy! I'm Lisa Kelly, and until then, I'll see you on the next one.